Ever since our program started, I've been thinking, when are we going to find a patient who can be liberated from LVAD support? Donna Jackson was one of the first patients that we placed an LVAD in at Stanford. When she came to me, she was very ill.
The way I knew I was getting sick is I started this cough. I got where I couldn't even walk from my car to the front door without having to stop and sit down and take deep breaths, trying to get my breathing back. I thought I just had bronchitis, but when I had the EKG done, the doctor, he said, the good news is that you have no blockages, but you're gonna have to have a heart transplant. I just went, what? He said, now you can go to San Francisco or you can go to Stanford. And I said, well, I will go to Stanford. They did a bunch of tests on me and talked to me about a LVAD. And I says, well, I don't know.
Left ventricular assist devices, or LVADs, serve patients who have mainly left ventricular heart failure. It's a device that are used only in patients who are bridged to transplant. We don't use that device in patients who are not on the transplant list.
At that time in our program, it was very early and people didn't know about LVADs, and there was some skepticism, maybe we can get her better with medications. But one problem with end-stage heart failure patients is that sometimes they're so sick that we can't even give them the therapies that they need for heart failure, because those therapies lower their blood pressure and give them symptoms. So that was the case in her. The benefit of having the LVAD was that we could give her more of the medications at the recommended doses.
I told him, I don't want a heart transplant. You know, I've lived my life. He said, but I had to be put on the transplant list because LVAD is only considered a bridge. He says, but if your name comes up, you can say no. And I told him, well, I have to think about it. And then my little granddaughter came in one night and she curled up on the bed with me and she goes, Grandma, I don't want you to die. And the next morning I woke up and didn't even think what I was gonna say or anything. I just came in, I told Cheryl, I said, I'll have the LVAD put in. Had it put in September of 2010. During the day, I wore two big batteries, one on each side. Plus, I had to carry two batteries and a controller in my purse. I had it on for 2 years and 7 months, and my heart was getting stronger.
I think your heart's recovering a little bit.
So I says, well, if my heart's getting strong enough, why can't we take it out?
She told us, you know, I want to go swimming. That's my favorite thing to do, and to swim with my granddaughter and do water aerobics with my best friend.
He says, well, we're not sure that you'll live. And I says, you know, we're talking about my quality of life, not my quantity. I said, I want my quality, even if it's just for a year.
We did the tests that were necessary to show that her heart had recovered, but I was really hesitant, to be honest, because it was a high-risk operation.
So then we thought, well, how can we help this woman? The way that we stopped the support on her was very innovative and has never been done in the country. And I think that has to go to our surgical team and interventional radiology team's credit. We thought, what if we can stop the support from the LVAD by putting a catheter inside her body, not doing an operation, and having it clot off? Then we could keep the LVAD in and just clip the line that comes out, and it would be a very minor procedure. She did very well with the surgery. Of course, she still needs very close monitoring, but she's smiling and she's happy. And I can happily tell you that she's swimming with her granddaughter last week.
I just enjoy being free.